His Excellency Mr. Mauricio Macri, President of the Argentine Republic, and I invite him to address the Assembly.
Señor Presidente.
Mr. President, Secretary General, distinguished heads of state and government, ladies and gentlemen. It is an honor for me once again to address this assembly a few months before my first mandate as president ends to share with you the path followed by Argentina in terms of our links with international society, a path that was characterized by playing a constructive role in order to together address global challenges, committing ourselves to searching for consensus and collective action, acting with the conviction that the world is much more an opportunity than it is a threat, and dedicated to building international trust, to diversifying partners, broadening areas for cooperation, and searching for areas where Argentina can play a relevant role, a leadership role. And the most important thing, a path that will also correspond to a profound aspiration of Argentine society, which wants to be part of the international order of the 21st century, because we are a diverse country, multicultural, of very many different origins, beliefs, and religions living peacefully together in a plural identity. It's because we appreciate dialogue and respect as forms for building a shared future. Mr. President, since I assumed office in 2015, we decided to leave behind us a stage of confrontation with the world and to take up our place on the international stage in an intelligent manner, but in a complex global context that is still uncertain, a lot of political tensions, we decided to assume our responsibility and make our contribution to strengthening multilateralism and global governance. This was reflected in the WTO ministerial conference at the G20 meeting and the UN conference on South-South cooperation held in Argentina over the last 3 years. Three meetings which placed Argentina on the world stage and brought the world to Argentina, where we demonstrated our ability to cooperate in building an international order that has room for all of us. But our responsibility to multilateralism and searching for consensus went much further than that. Over these years, Argentina also has secured its positive role in strengthening international peace and security, contributing in the areas of peaceful use of nuclear energy, space development, fighting terrorism, and combating transnational organized crime, amongst many other things. We express here, once again, our robust commitment to non-proliferation, a commitment which has been a pillar of democratic consensus over recent decades in Argentina and which guides our development of nuclear technology. In 2020, my country will chair the review conference of the parties to the Treaty on the Non-Proliferation of Nuclear Weapons, and we also hope to be able to make a contribution through our candidate to be Director General of the International Atomic Energy Agency. Mr. President, the commitment of Argentina to fighting terrorism in all its forms is firmer than it has ever been. This year, we organized the Second Hemispheric Ministerial Conference on the Fight Against Terrorism. We have strengthened, with the support of other countries and international organizations, the exchange of information and the measures aimed at preventing its financing. We also created a database to facilitate the freezing of assets suspected to be linked to terrorist activities, which made it possible, for example, for the financial Argentine Information Unit to be able to freeze the assets of persons and entities related to Hezbollah. Despite all of these efforts, Argentines still have open wounds. We continue to fight the impunity for the attacks that we suffered in 1992 on the Embassy of Israel and in 1994 on the headquarters of AMIA, which led to the deaths of 107 people and hundreds of wounded. We want all those involved in the attacks to face Argentine courts so that they can be brought to justice and, where appropriate, sentenced. 25 years on from the most brutal terrorist attack on our country, once again we call upon the Islamic Republic of Iran to cooperate with the Argentine judicial authorities in order to make progress in the investigation of the attack on AMIA. And we reiterate our request for cooperation from friendly countries in order to avoid that those charged will be either hosted or sheltered under diplomatic immunity. Mr. President, since I assumed the presidency, I proceeded without hesitation to fight drug trafficking and money laundering. We increased the quantity of drugs seized and the captures of fugitives, national and international. We dismantled criminal drug networks and we reduced the homicides linked to drug trafficking throughout the country. Last year, for example, we froze more than 500 billion pesos linked to organized crime. That's equivalent to around $8.5 billion. And we also sped up the time needed to bring to judgment cases relating to money laundering and corruption, and we seized goods and property of persons charged with these crimes. Also, we have continued to work with the governments of Latin America and the Caribbean to achieve the consensus necessary for creating a regional legal body that is able to address this and other types of transnational organized crime. Mr. President, over these past years, we have demonstrated a renewed and ambitious commitment to fighting climate change, and we have committed ourselves to sustainable development. We are aware of the climate emergency, and we must act in accordance with the Paris commitments. That is why we have taken the decision to engage in a low emission policy, which will make it possible for us to move to more ambitious targets, such as carbon neutrality by 2050. This initiative is supported by the efforts that we are making today in the area, for example, of cleaner energy, particularly renewable energy, energy efficiency, conservation of ecosystems, a doubling of the surface area of national parks, the creation of marine protected areas, taking care of our forests and increasing forestation, capturing carbon in the soil, and also promoting technologies for sustainable agriculture, promoting good livestock practices as well, and reducing emissions in the transport sector. Mr. President, over these years, equality between men and women was much more than a simple matter of policy for Argentina. It's an unfailing commitment to continue to empower women and girls, removing the gaps in employment, education, and political participation. We implemented the Equal Opportunities Plan and Equal Rights Plan, which aims not only to prevent but also to assist women that have been victims of violence. We established the gender parity law for parliamentary office, and we designed our national budget with an egalitarian strategy in mind. We know that we still have a lot to do, but we are sure that there is no turning back when it comes to rights and opportunities that today women have in my country. Mr. President, a multilateral system and more efficient global governance, as well as a safer and more peaceful world, require that regions be more stable, more interconnected, and also connected to the rest of the world. That is why we, appreciating regional integration, since the first day of our administration, we decided to make a firm commitment to Mercosur. Combining the positions of the four partners, we set in train an adaptation of the system to the 21st century so that it could become a competitive and dynamic bloc with clear rules of the game. We gave it a renewed and ambitious boost internally and externally with actions and specific success stories that benefited our citizens. And now, after more than 20 years of negotiations, we've achieved an agreement with the European Union, an unprecedented agreement for both blocs, one of the most important agreements globally. And this is going to make it possible for us to promote trade and investment and have a positive impact on the quality of life of our peoples. Although it's an important step forward, the most important thing, as in life in general, is the path that you follow. We now have a Mercosur that is modern and open to the world. Mr. President, I am convinced that the path taken by a country on the global stage requires values to guide its action. Our history and our geography unite us in a region which profoundly appreciates democracy, freedom, and human rights as a way of living and as a means for peaceful coexistence. And that is why, from the beginning of our administration, we led the condemnation of the very serious situation of human rights violations in Venezuela, demonstrated by the report of the United Nations High Commissioner for Human Rights. The dictatorship of Nicolas Maduro led Venezuela into an unprecedented humanitarian crisis. The massive exodus of millions of Venezuelans has seriously affected the stability and governance of our region. Once again, I would like to call upon the international community to use all diplomatic and legal tools available to reverse this situation so that Venezuela once again may live in freedom and democracy. Mr. President, Argentina reaffirms the legitimate and imprescriptible sovereign rights of Argentina over the Malvinas, South Georgia, and the South Sandwich Islands and the surrounding maritime areas. And we remain prepared and call once again upon the United Kingdom to renew bilateral negotiations which will enable us to find a peaceful and lasting solution to the dispute. Nevertheless, we have created a new relationship framework with the UK, and thus we have improved conditions to progress towards a solution. Part of this, working together with the Red Cross, was to identify the majority of the Argentine soldiers buried in the Darwin Cemetery, thus settling a historic debt to the families. We've also renewed scientific cooperation in the fisheries sector, including by carrying out joint scientific maritime missions, and we have promoted greater closeness between the islands and continental Argentina by establishing a new weekly flight to the Malvinas. Mr. President, before concluding, I would like to tell you that in this situation of uncertainty that Argentines are facing at the moment, today, my absolute priority is to be there for all of them and to help them to get through these difficult times. And without neglecting this responsibility, I decided to come here to share with you this assessment of Argentina's role on the global stage over the last 4 years. Because given the trends towards fragmentation, I believe that the best answer in order to progress towards a prosperous future is more cooperation, more and better multilateralism. Because I am convinced that in order to grow and develop, in order to have the life that Argentines deserve, we have to become more integrated in the world and thus deploy all of our labor and all of our talent. I know that we can do this. The outcome depends on us. Thank you very much to you all.
Au nom de l'Assemblée.
On behalf of the General Assembly, I wish to thank His Excellency, the President of the Argentine Republic, for the statement made. May I request representatives to remain seated while the Deputy Secretary General and myself greet the President.